Let it start. So let's have a go. It's 1:42. And let's start it like this. We'll start the music off as long as we can. Hello, I'm Randomize, and welcome to my playthrough of Pokemon Blue. I'm relatively new to the Pokemon game, the whole series as a whole, but I've played through Red, and I've played through Fire Red, so it should be interesting, but I'll soon be moving on to Uncharted Waters, hopefully with playthroughs of Gold and Silver and the other games which I haven't played. So yeah, we'll get started here. I'm currently using OpenMU on my Mac as an emulator. And downloaded the ROM for this. I'm just going to use it for this. We'll start off, and I'm going to use Blue because why not? And I'm also going to keep the standard rival name for just normal sake. So, use Red, I am Blue. My own Pokemon legend is about 24, so yeah, we'll use it for all this. And now, very quickly, I'm just going to mute because I'm going to be fast forwarding through all this using the fast forward button on the emulator, and it wrecks the audio. So we'll just do that. So we'll take out the potion from our PC because I don't know why we have one there, but yeah, we'll leave our mum and we enter Pallet Town. Shades of your journey await. Could talk to this person, but she just says that she's raising Pokemon to protect her. This guy tells us that technology has allowed you to store Pokemon via PC, which is a crazy concept when you think about it. And Mum just says, "All boys leave home someday," because it says so on TV. Obviously, Professor Oak, if you know, played this game before, you know Professor Oak is not in his lab at the moment. This is our rival Blue's house. Instead, we must trigger this event. It's unsafe, wild Pokemon live in tall grass. Indeed. So, he comes in, we go back to the lab, and he gives us a new Pokemon, and we meet up with our rival. So, I've played through before with Squirtle and with Bulbasaur. I was, and I've enjoyed playing through those, but I think this time I'm going to use Charmander, because why not for a different thing? So yes, I do want Charmander. Do you want to give a nickname to? I'm not going to be nicknaming most of the Pokemon. Sorry about that. I'm really bad at nicknames. So, I might do it on other playthroughs, but for the moment, no. So our rival takes a Squirtle, which should be interesting, and then we can talk to him again. He tells us that our Pokemon can battle, and then we get our first trainer battle against our rival. And it looks for the moment that I was slightly faster, but unfortunately he's actually relatively clever. I mean, I've only got Growl. Growl won't do much. So we use the potion, get that. The reason you want to win that is purely just really for the money you get. He says he's going to go toughen up his Pokemon. We have old girl here who tells us that Professor Oak is the authority. And then we have the aids, which obviously give us various HMs and stuff during the course of the game. So now we zip up to Route 1 and our first through wild Pokemon, the Pidgey and the Rattata. See. Zip through that. bit too much damage. I'm just going to heal here. And then we'll go back through one. We'll come up through here. Talk to this guy. He'll give us a potion from the Pokemart. And then we'll continue up. This guy will tell us about ledges and how that we can jump down but not up, which I always think is a pretty silly way of working it out. And we reach Viridian City. Yeah, we have power points and PP. This dude here tells us, what do you do? Come on. Pokeballs at your waist. You have Pokemon. It's great that you can carry Pokemon anytime, anywhere. Yeah. And Viridian is the eternally green paradise. So this guy stops us from going any further forward, so we need to go to the Pokemart. And this guy has, yes, so you come from the Pallet Town. So, it's the Rokes. You get his parcel. Go down. I'll just quickly heal in the Pokemon Center. And then we go back down Route 1. I'll go through the battle areas anyway, just for experience. It's obviously not worth that much, but I want to be level 10 by, you know, a decent amount. Yeah, I'll probably grind here just for a bit, just to get to level 10. Certainly level 9. Level 9, I think I earn Ember, and then I can just smoke Viridian Forest. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. He's got a custom Pokeball, and then he comes along, and he seems very absent-minded, but yeah. So now we get our Pokédex. In general, I will be trying to complete a larger number of Pokémon. Generally, I'm probably going to try and catch the first evolutionary stage of each evolutionary family. So, you know, Staryu and Horsey and Goldeen, as opposed to Starmie, Seedra, and Seaking. It's just personal preference. I find it a lot easier. I think, in general, I might do a lot of the catching off screen just because I know that catching certain Pokemon, like Chansey, Scyther, anything like that, can be a real bitch task, so you know, just for speed's sake, I might either fast forward through it or just do that off screen and show you guys later. Anyway, we're still far too powerful with the Route 1 enemies, so we'll zip up, keep going. Okay, and now we'll talk to some people. So we got the guy in the Pokemon. We've got a few guys in the Pokemon Center who tell us it's a Pokemon Center in every town ahead. They don't charge any money either. We've got this guy who talks about how the Pokemon Center heals us, and this guy who just says that we can use the PC to store either store Pokemon or store items, which we'll probably do because the item bag in this sort of game is awful. This guy tells us about the Caterpillar Pokemon. So we have Caterpie has no poison, but Weedle does. And for that very reason, I'm going to the Pokemon Mart to get a fair amount of Pokeballs. And then I'm going to get some antidotes. And a Paralseal, just because I hate paralysis in this game, is actually very important, the speed difference and the potential to lose a turn is never nice. So, yep, potions are all sorted out, as we just found out. Many antidotes, but there's only one we need to worry about, which is that for, I've spoken to you, that for, you know, the poison status. This person talks about Pokeballs can be catched. You can just find out all this stuff. Pretty random that it's in the school book. So it says, yep, poison burns another damage are effective. Yep, battles are at Pokemon Gyms. The goal for Pokemon trainers is to beat the top 8 gym leaders. Do so the rate the Elite Four. And she tells us not to look at the notes, but we just did. This person tells us to read the blackboard. You can obviously see that poison of Pokemon has deadly drops. Poisoning is after a battle. Obviously, we use antidotes. Paralysis could make poison moves from its fire, and it remains after battles. Fails to describe the actual speed difference. Pokemon can't attack it if it's asleep. Sleep is really annoying for certain Pokemon, at least. But burn. Burn reduces power and speed, also causes ongoing damage. Anyway, we've also got frozen and the immobilization. And obviously, freezing is a lot more potent in these early, certainly in Gen 1, just because the chance of blizzard freezing is like 30% in this game, and it's like 10% in every game afterwards, so it sort of nerfs it. Which is a pity, because ice is like, I always think ice is a pretty cool and, pretty cool element, pretty cool type, Pokemon type in this game. Anyway, we finally have Ember, and Ember obviously gives us the same type attack boosts, and if we needed any more help to kill these guys, we can. I'm going to get up to level 10, and then, I just remembered I can catch these guys now. You forgot. Yeah, I can catch, so that level 3 for Ember takes it out. Pidgey, I'll Ember it, and then I will use a Pokeball. And I've caught my first Pokemon, and it's like so many before, it's a Pidgey. So like I said before, I probably won't be catching Pidgeotto in the wild if they do appear. I think they do at some point, but I'm quite happy just to catch a Pidgey and be happy with that. All I need to do is catch a Rattata, which shouldn't also be too difficult a task. There we go, Rattata. Scratch it, and then our second Pokemon, Rattata. As you might expect, neither of these Pokemon are going to be making it into my final team. Quite decided what I want for my final team. The lack of fly on Charizard in first gen is very annoying and sort of limits me as to what I might choose. But I think I'll keep that in mind. Anyway, we'll head up here first because there's a secret potion up here, and then we'll head to Route 25 and we'll do a little bit more battles down here. Ahead of facing our rival briefly and his single Pidgey. And his Squirtle, which will finally know a water attack. So it could be a bit of an issue, but I doubt I'll lose again. I have enough potions to sort of supply me. Nidoran! Another new Pokemon. Nidoran I might use. Maybe, don't know, probably not, we'll see. I use Pokeball and I catch a female Nidoran. So see, female Nidoran are more present in blue, and male Nidoran are found more common in red. Just how the game distributes its Pokemon. Okay. Strain these guys, it's pretty simple. I want to see if I can catch a male one, if not. Just go around a few more times, another female. I remember doing this off screen and I got like a female and a male like twice, the males are only like 5% though, so I will go until I go up to level 12 and go back, heal, and get some EP back. So PP, EP, so used to other stuff. So yeah, I mean, everyone knows that grinding is a part of this game. You just gotta get through it. Pro- probably won't be using many repels, just so you know. I tend to play a lot of the random encounters, although you know, they certainly can be annoying in certain areas of the game. So anyway, we'll come back. I know in some versions there are Mankey in here as well, so I don't know. Oh, by the way, the Rattata. We have to come back here anyway, so it's fine. Probably kill him in one hit though by the time I come back. Yep, right, I have no badges, so I can't go, but it seems very happy in telling me that, and I will. Just sound attacks me. This is really annoying. So we sort of hope that Scratch will eventually hit. If it doesn't. Okay, there we go. And oh. Just going to use a potion because if I remember, bubbles seem to take off quite a lot of health. Yep, in the end, defeat. Chandler gets all the experience, which is important. So yeah, another successful victory against Red, and there we go, a male Nidoran. Scratch it, great, did not kill it, and we'll use a Pokeball. There we go, Pokemon number 4. I really know which I prefer of the two Nidoran. I think generally, Nidoqueen's more bulky and Nidoking is more attack minded. But yeah, no, it's going well so far. So we'll zip up, we'll talk to this girl. She has to take the winding trail in Viridian Forest, which is where we'll be going. I've had my coffee now and I feel great. Sure, you can go through. Are you in a hurry? I think this is the tutorial of how to catch Pokemon. We'll just do this. Oh no, it's just talking about. Ah, here we go. Yeah, so a wild weirdo. He goes to Pokeball. He's like, so we've already caught this, so we don't really need to see this, but yeah. It says it's important to weaken, and obviously that. And obviously the other thing, Viridian Gym. This Pokemon Gym is always closed. I wonder who the leader is. And the great mystery is soon to be solved. Anyway, we move now on to Route 2, which will take us to Viridian Forest. Is it through here and our first few battles? But in first we have a Caterpie. Now, Caterpie is an important Pokemon for me because, because Charmander is obviously pretty much useless against Brock. And his Geodude and his Onix. So it's very important that I so I'm just going to deposit some Pokemon. Now, okay. So yeah, I mean, like I was saying, Charmander is pretty useless against Onix, you know, the rock Pokemon, with fire being useless and that normal attacks are weak against fire. So sorry, against rocks. So I'm going to use Caterpie, and we'll see how that will work out. This girl talks asks us if we got a Rattata. Dude, but we're not going to use him. That's Viridian Forest. We're going to swap out Caterpie, and we're going to keep bringing him in and out of the gap. And then this person talks about how he went, came here with his friends. If you search this side, you find an antidote. Another helpful thing. There are Pikachu in this forest. Every now and again you find them. So often I don't. Metapod will just die. But it's, you know, it's not that bad experience for either of them. And I just need to get Caterpie up to level 10. Level 10 should be too difficult, I wouldn't have thought. Don't really want to use them up against these other Caterpies, so we'll just nail them. We'll see what happens. is faster than me already, so it looks like I can spam tackle and get, there we go, level 5. Find a Pokeball up there, got another Caterpie, if we just tackle it, it will survive. Use another one, we'll go to Charmander, and Charmander can just Ember these guys. Obviously Bug being weak to fire. So we use this for poison, use antidote, get to Pokemon marks. Yeah. I haven't met a single Weedle yet, and I'm not sure whether that's because Weedles are rare in this version. It might well be, I know that my red playthroughs, they were generally quite poor. Common, so it might just be that they are common only in red and not in blue. I don't know for sure. Then we'll just smoke these guys, get up to level 6. Now we're down to 1 health, so it should be interesting. Although, Metapod, we could waste our time trying to bash down the door, as it were. But no, Metapod goes easily down. We're trying to avoid battles, but why would you want to avoid battles? Okay. So, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's pretty easy progress at the moment. It's just a matter of. Destroying these Caterpie and Metapod. I haven't seen a single Weedle yet, which is interesting. That's my other choice, but I've decided not to use Weedle at the moment. Could also use. But I could catch a Pikachu, which would be quite nice. Just because you don't get another electric Pokemon really until Magnemite outside Rock Tunnel and. Not great. I usually find Pikachu over here. I wonder if I'll find any. Be interesting. So if I can kill this Caterpie because he's a level down on me. And we'll get him up to a Metapod sooner rather than later. There we go. Hello, my Metapod. It's kind of weird that Metapod doesn't learn Harden. The only way you get a Harden. Well, it might learn, I can't remember now. Seems like it hasn't, though. Maybe it learns it in level 8. Makes it out like that. But yeah, zip through again. Okay, now. Really not that difficult. We're going to face our first trainer battles soon. Obviously, the good thing about trainer battles is that the experience you get from them is just so much better. Swap out because quick experience. Easiest to do like this. Metapod's up to level 8. I mean, again, you know, it's very difficult to actually use this guy until. It's very difficult to use, you know, Caterpie until you evolve it into a Butterfree. We'll zip around. What did you have to say? You better catch some stronger Pokemon, otherwise, I'm just going to keep on beating you. But obviously, they don't. I always find it amusing how literally all of the bug catchers you see have rubbish Pokemon. Level 6 Weedle. Let's see. Okay. He's super effective because I always find it one of the oddities in the early parts of this game is that poison is super effective against bug, but bug is super effective against poison. It's the only time in the Pokemon history, I think that actually was the case, until they corrected it Gen 2. So yeah. So yeah, I defeated that guy and his Caterpie and his Weedle. So we'll zoom up. This. There we can get our Pokedex evaluated by Professor Oak. Another Metapod. Really surprised by the lack of Kakuna and Weedle. I guess Weedle must be like a rare in this. Because these guys are just like all over the place. I always remember seeing a decent amount of Caterpie, so I don't I just. This feels a bit weird, but no. Looks like I can kill this guy by myself. So, yeah. Maybe I'm just searching in the wrong places. I have no idea if there are Pikachu in this edition. If there are, I might go back. I might go try anyway. So yeah, we'll see what happens. So yeah, it looks like I'm coming to the half hour mark, and I'm hoping to sort of keep these episodes to half an hour each. So hopefully, if I start moving forwards, I'll be able to get to the end of Viridian Forest within the next few. Within the next few minutes. Good, no random encounters. The potion. What does the sign say? No stealing Pokemon from other trainers, yeah. I wonder how long it was before they enforced that rule. Love to get Butterfree soon. Not sure I'm gonna get Butterfree this episode. I'm just not. I should get Butterfree. I'm just not sure I'm gonna be able to get what I need from Butterfree. The attack in particular. You've got a level 9 Weedle, which should at least be a Kakuna. Let's see. I'll use it through. He says he's dropped something. It usually means there's something around him. Whether you can find it or not. Another Metapod, so yeah. It doesn't look like I can find it. I can't quite remember where it is. It might be here facing the woods. No. Come on, turn around. Oh well, it's a meta. Leaving Viridian Forest, so yeah. And you. Yep, specific bushes for a specific Pokemon move. These annoying cut bushes, which we can't do for a minute. Anyway, I'm going to get to Viridian City, and I will save, and that'll be it for this first episode of this new new Let's Play. Quickly, this dude. I have no idea what you're doing. Keep you repelled. Future City, a stone grey city. Apt with its stone grey Pokemon. And then we've got Museum, which I'm not going to do at the moment because obviously we should have cut to get in that way. Pewter Museum of Science. Something up there, I'm not going to try. Yep. Clefairies might be from the moon, which the anime sort of alludes to as well. All the Pokemon trainers are just like bug catchers, and we will see. So we'll stop here. Got to Pewter City. Tomorrow we'll be taking on Brock.